Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Welcome to another video. Today's video, we are passing over to Brian from Automate Your Life. Brian runs a YouTube channel dedicated to talking all about Amazon smart devices. And on today's video, Brian's gonna deep dive into how to connect Todoist with your Amazon smart devices. This is gonna be an exciting feature because I know many of you have some Amazon smart devices and would love to connect it with Todoist. And some of you guys need a bit of an explainer and also how to use the simple list abilities that has. So guys, I'm gonna pass you over to Brian. I've been a follower for Brian for quite a while now, been enjoying his content. So if you wanna go over there and subscribe and actually learn more about Amazon smart devices in general, that's the perfect place. So I'm gonna pass you into the capable hands, Brian. Thank you very much, and over to you, Brian.
Thank you, Francesco. I am so excited. This is actually my first full collaboration. I am so excited to do this with you. So what I am and who I am is I am part of a channel called Automate Your Life. And what we do is we help you apply home automation and life automation technology to you, your life, and even your business to help you get further and further ahead and keep more productive. So let's go ahead. And what I want to show you today is how to integrate Todoist with your Amazon Echo series of products. So let's get going. So there's two components that I basically want to start with here before we walk through how to actually apply this to your life. You need to get some of that background information in order to kind of do things right. Now, Todoist is an application that I think most people on this channel will be familiar with. So I'm going to really briefly go through what it is and what it can do. You can create different tasks in different projects. So you can create different projects, break up how you're managing different components of your life or your business. And you can also attach things like a schedule or when you want to complete each task. And then you can go ahead, you can label those with different labels for how they apply to a project or to something in your life. And then of course, you can invite other people in and go ahead and utilize that functionality of having someone else actually complete a task for you and really start to manage a business or even in your own household, manage household tasks. So really it's a task management suite, and that's what we're here to integrate with these Echo products. Now switching over there, you're going to need the application, and I'll just put it on the screen here because I never want to say that wake word. It always triggers devices like these. Now, Amazon Echo has a whole series of products. So I'll kind of run you through a couple of the products here, then we'll talk about the application and how they do their own lists capability here. So this is an older Echo Plus. This is the first generation device. The Echo Plus 2, this is the second generation of the device. You can see much shorter, a little bit wider. And overall, I think they look a lot nicer. They're intended to really sit anywhere in your home. But these are really, really powerful devices. Moving over here, we have the Amazon Echo Dot. This is the third generation of their tiny, tiny little speaker. So to give you an idea, this is $50 US. So you can have this capability in your home for $50 US. What's amazing is this is called a Fire HD tablet. This is the 8-inch, and they actually have the same voice assistant on board that all of these devices have. And you can now basically set this up as a display device. And in Canada here, they're $80 Canadian. I mean, it's ridiculous, actually, the price that you're getting that kind of level of functionality from. So this is just some of the devices that Amazon has in their Echo series or Fire series in the case of this tablet. And all of them have that voice assistant on board, which allows you to use this great list functionality that I'm going to show you next. So I'm inside the application here, and I'm just on the main page or the home page here. And what I want to do is I want to show you the list functionality. And actually, my device is going through an update here, but inside that menu, here are the lists, and you can see there's some really good functionality here. You have a shopping list and you have a to-do list right off the bat, and those are native capabilities. So you can always ask your device to create something on that, on either of those lists. So let's go ahead and do that. Echo, add milk to my shopping list.
I've added milk to your shopping list.
Echo. Add create Francesco's video to my to-do list.
I've added create Francesco's video to your to-do list.
So there you go. I just added two items, and let me show you here in the shopping list. I've added milk. You can see it right there. And in my to-do list, you can see it even spelled Francesco's name right here to create Francesco's video. So really simple functionality or really simple management or creation of items in those lists. So you get those two basic list capabilities here within your Echo suite of devices, but you also get the ability to create custom lists and then manage those tasks and lists within those. So let's go ahead, we'll create a new whole list, a whole custom list, and then we'll go ahead and we'll manage some of the tasks we have throughout the day here. So let's go ahead. Echo. Create a new list called Francesco's video.
Create a list called Francesco's video, right?
Yes.
I've created Francesco's video list. What should I add to it?
Film.
I've added film to your Francesco's video list. Any other items?
No.
Okay.
So you can see right there, as soon as I created it, Francesco's video list came up and you can see the task right there is already there. So now I know that I have to film. Now if I want, from the application, I can add additional things. So we'll just say, okay, I've got to edit Francesco's video because he's a slave driver. But you know, there it is. I have now two different things in that list. It's a task list. Now, what I'll tell you about these custom lists is they don't integrate really well with Todoist, but you can access them on your device. So let's go ahead and access some of these custom lists. Echo, what's in my Francesco's video list?
You have two items on your Francesco's video list, edit and film.
Echo, what items are in Francesco's video list?
You have two items on your Francesco's video list, edit and film.
Echo, remove edit from Francesco's video list.
I've checked off edit from Francesco's video.
So there you go, you can manage items within here. So this capability is the same when we talk about integration with Todoist. So let's get into that integration. Now, I've actually already connected my services, but I'm going to show you where you can go inside the application to do that. So in the top left, there's the menu button and down to settings at the very bottom. Now you have to scroll all the way down and you can see lists right here. And when I tap on lists, there's a number of connected services. And Francesco and I talked about rolling through lots of these, but you know, I think Todoist really hits most of the notes. You know, I've used Cozy in the past and I have some friends who use Cozy as well. The integration is really similar. There's some little nuances between each of these, but ultimately all I had to do was hit the plus, and then what I got was an enable button on this page. So instead of it saying settings and disable skill, it said enable, and when I hit enable, I had to log into my page. That's really all that has to happen here for you to integrate your Todoist account and your Amazon Echo series of products. So once you've done that, the really interesting piece to me here is you can integrate your shopping list, you can integrate your to-do list, and that's integrated natively. Those two things are basically there natively. And so what happens over in Todoist here, as I switch over to that application, is you end up with these other this other project here called the shopping list. Now, the shopping list basically has on it, and you can see there's the other thing that I added. I added milk to the list here today on this demo with that device. So that's as fast as the passing of information can be between these two applications. There are times when I see a delay of passing back and forth, but in general, this works completely seamlessly. So now over in Todoist, if I'd like, I can go ahead and you know that you can manage all of these different things. I can edit for when I'd like to do it, and I can move it to a different project if I'd like. So just in terms of a shopping list, I'll go ahead and I'll check off milk there, and that's now gone. So if I head back to the Amazon list, It's just getting taken away here. You saw as I switched the screen, sometimes, again, it'll take a minute or so to actually have that show up as removed. But you can see how quick that integration can be when all the services are basically running at full speed. Now, of course, you already saw me do that by voice. I could remove eggs by voice and it will proliferate all the way to Todoist. So, you know, that's really powerful functionality, but we're getting, and I kind of saved the best for last here, the to-do list. What I really love about this is the fact that your to-do list shows up based on some rules coming from Todoist itself. Now, you can go ahead and you can put anything on your to-do list, and I'll show you how that works and what that shows up like over in Todoist. But whenever you remove one here, it again, it removes it from Todoist. It closes off that action basically as of today. And the other piece that I love is it's only showing you here in your to-do list what you have to do today. So it brings that up, and it also brings up things that are overdue. So you're able to just ask what's on your to-do list through your Echo device. So let's go ahead and see all these different items. You can see there's 5 on my to-do list today. Echo, what's on my to-do list for today?
You have 5 items on your to-do list. Create Francesco's video. Film EP1, of course. Testing again Alexa integration. Make an Echo setup video. And test this out.
Remove test this out from my to-do list.
I've checked off test this out from to-do.
All right, so you could see I was able to ask what was on my to-do list and I got everything back. And then I was able to actually mark something off as completed on my list. I marked off the test this out. Now, as I skip over to Todoist, you can see that test this out is not here on the today schedule. So everything basically that's here for today or that has already passed is showing up in that to-do list. Now, you'll see here, there's 5 items here, and let me skip back to my Echo application here. Sorry, I almost said the wake word, but you can see there's only 4 here. Now, why is that? Well, that's because I set an actual time for prepping Mark's video. So that's why it's not showing up. You have to be mindful of when you create a task here in Todoist, what time you set for that will actually say when it shows up on your to-do list. So some other things to note here, you'll notice that as you roll through the different tasks here I have today, some of them are in one project, some of them are in another project, and to be honest, it doesn't matter which project list they're in. It also doesn't matter the labels or any of those things. That just doesn't matter. What matters is, has the time passed, then it will show up on the to-do list in your Echo device. The other thing you can do is you can set or create to-do items to head over to Todoist. So let me show you what happens when you create an item here and how it integrates with Todoist. Add an item to my to-do list.
What can I add for you?
Send Francesco a message Tuesday.
Send Francesco message Tuesday added to your to-do list.
Now, what you saw right there, and this will, I'll probably have to replay that on the screen here. It showed up on the screen that San Francesco message Tuesday showed up and then it disappeared. Now, I could have just created one that said San Francesco message and it would stay there. So I'm going to create a second one and then I'm going to show you the difference between the two. Create an item on my to-do list.
What's the to-do?
Send Keep Productive a message.
Send Keep Productive a message added to your to-do list.
All right, so moving over to Todoist here again, just to show you kind of those nuances. You saw me do 2 things. I basically created one without a day or a time, and then I created another with a day and a time. And if you've used Todoist before, you know that basically putting the word Tuesday or today, which does work here on your Echo device, creating that, putting that in the name of the list actually means that over here in Todoist, it will move to that day. Now, I didn't put one on this send, keep productive a message, so it just stuck it as today. It stuck it as something I have to do immediately, so you can go ahead and you could just manage as you go. If you think of something, and this is the real power of using this with Todoist, you think of something, you just simply tell it to add it to your to-do list, and it shows up here as an item. Now, you can go ahead, of course, and you can manage that item, so you could set reminders, you could do anything basically that you can do with this. Of course, you can check it off. You can move it between projects, and like I said, it doesn't matter if it's in the business tasks project, it will still show up in your to-do list. It doesn't matter which project that's in here. You could, of course, assign it to other people, set it as a different priority. All of those different things and the labels and the parents, you can go ahead and you can do that. I'm not gonna tell you how to do that because you already know how you wanna organize your to-do list here. But you can see I've adjusted it, it's business tasks, and it's still over here in this application, in the Echo management application here. It hasn't moved, it's not going anywhere. But we still haven't found that other task that I said on Tuesday. So I'm going to go back here and go to the next 7 days and scroll down basically to Tuesday. Now, I was creating multiple here just to demonstrate some things for myself and then prep. So you actually can see two of these messages, but basically the send Francesco a message is showing up here on Tuesday. It will show up in my application on Tuesday on this device as a to-do item, and it won't show up until then. So I can still come here in Todoist and review. I can't access these from my Echo device. I can't access these ones that are in later days. They're just not showing up in the application yet. But what I can do is I can create them for those days by simply adding that word Tuesday or today to any of the tasks that I create in that to-do list on my Echo device. So now, of course, that doesn't mean that I can't manage here in Todoist. I can totally manage these tasks. You've seen this before in the video. I can hit the completed there, and as soon as I go back here, we've seen it where it will manage it. I can hit refresh, and then it'll pull that out of the application. You can see it deleted that task from my to-do list. So there you go, guys. I think this is a really good setup and tutorial video for how to apply some of these Echo devices to your life and to keep you more productive here with Francesco and his channel. You can really get integrating these. So of course, thanks everyone for watching me here, for sticking with me through this tutorial. If there's any questions, of course, Francesco and I will work together to answer your questions here. And thanks again to Francesco for having me on Keep Productive. And I can't wait to see you all come on over to Automate Your Life. Join me on that channel there, and you're gonna see all kinds of integration and creative ways to basically implement this technology in your life. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.